Morning, everyone. Josh and Justin, we're here at Santa Monica Farmers Market. It's a beautiful Wednesday morning.
It's gonna be a beautiful day. Sun's coming out. It's a little cold right now, but I'm excited because it's definitely gonna get turned up in the heat, and we're gonna turn it up in the heat because we're gonna be looking for something super special today.
Yeah, we're adding the spice. We're gonna be making a Puerto Rican dish, which is really special and close to my heart because mama's Puerto Rican. And so can't wait to go check it out.
And I'm really excited because that means we can do a little bit of the salsa dancing, which I love.
Whoa. Give him space. All right, well, you want to go check out the Nuvo booth and go talk a little bit about fresh olive oil?
Let's talk about it. Yeah, looking forward to it.
Awesome. Well, welcome back to another episode of In Season
with Nuvo
and Friends. All right, here we are at the Nuvo booth in Santa Monica. And I'm really excited because here every other Wednesday, we've got Nathan and Matt. Nathan is my brother and Matt has been with us since day one. There'd be no Nuvo without these two guys. So say hello, everyone.
How's it going?
Hello, everyone.
So you know, we're here, we're doing our in-season video, and why don't you tell the viewers a little bit about why you like working the farmer market here?
It's just an amazing market. Farmer only, easily the most stands out of any of the markets that we're in. The chefs that come through here that I've been able to meet has been really, really awesome. And just so many reasons. Could go on and on.
Every week I'm learning about new varieties of fruits and vegetables and flowers I've never seen before. Pin cushions, they're just incredible.
Pin cushions?
Yeah, I've never seen.
Is that a food?
It's a flower.
Flower?
But it looks like a pin cushion where you would poke it. But
wow.
It's really interesting things every week. We're always seeing new things and always learning from other farmers and the customers as well.
Yeah, this market has tons of the staples, but then even things that I've never even heard about. It's like a pin cushion that you eat.
Right? Always learn something new.
Absolutely, yeah, especially at this market. I know you're excited to be here today.
I am excited to be here today. I love this market for all the reasons the guy said. You know, we're looking for something really specific in that we're going to be making some beans because Nathan and Josh, you guys being Puerto Rican and all, but we're also going to be using two of our oils in this dish for this episode. We're going to be using our cooking oil, our everyday all-purpose, and our early harvest. So maybe you want to tell our viewers a little bit about what makes both those oils so special.
Yeah, I really love the early harvest. Gosh, I'm just going to grab it here. Yeah. I consider it to be the creme de la creme of all of our products. Young picked olive, very nutrient dense, great for finishing on dishes. And think what your guys' intentions are going to be.
That's exactly right.
Just an amazing product.
Excellent in the beans and the chilies and hearty dishes, a robust olive oil.
Exactly, that'll be the finisher. And then we're going to use the everyday to like saute the veggies and get the base going, right? Lay that foundation. Gotta get that base on, right? Get the base, the basic step.
The base, the one, basic. Two. Go hand right? in hand, you know?
That's how it goes. So, yeah, so we're gonna go head over to Two Peas in a Pod.
Should you go guys check. Know them, right?
Yeah,
great,
yeah,
definitely.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Delicious products they have.
Yep. Yeah.
Awesome.
Very cool. That's what I love about the market. You actually do a great job of connecting the market, you know, getting vendors to know one another. And
it's very fun to do. I mean, it's a great part of the whole thing. It's like just such a family here of vendors. And
yeah, exactly.
It's fun to be a part of that whole circle, definitely, that connects the farmers and us and the chef. It's like a really cool triangle. Yeah.
We love people and we love providing them with fresh ingredients.
That's it.
For their families.
Well, we got to go pick up some ingredients.
Guys, thanks so much.
Thanks for stopping by.
Have a great day, you guys.
Thanks.
No, appreciate it. Thanks, guys. Boom. All right, we made it here to Two Peas in a Pod, and we're here with Zach. Zach is one of the owners. Zach, why don't you tell me a little bit about the history of the farm, where you guys are located, what you grow?
We are up in San Luis Obispo on the Central Coast. The name of the farm is Two Peas in a Pod. The reason for that is back in 1985, my father and my mom had the idea of trying a new crop, so they tried sugar snap peas. So they were the first people in the Central Coast to plant sugar snap peas. And to this day, we're still growing them, and that's kind of where the two peas came from, the mom and the pop.
Wow, and there's sugar snap peas all over the Central Coast now, right?
Yeah, it's actually the one of the biggest pea growing regions in California. Probably top two or three.
Wow, that's amazing vision. That's phenomenal.
Pioneers. Two pioneers. That's amazing.
What a risk. And so, you know, today we're going after the scarlet red beans because we're going to be cooking up this awesome Puerto Rican dish. You know, my mom's Puerto Rican, so we're doing a little Puerto Rican thing, and we hope you like it because we're going to bring it back to you. But what can you tell us about the beans? Any nutritional value or anything you like about it? Any qualities you like?
Along with peas, another thing we're known for is beans. We have, you know, 10 to 12 different varieties going at a time. The beans you guys are planning on using are scarlet runners. Really cool thing about those is that is like a special heirloom bean to us. We actually have been growing that bean for over 30 years. And what's happened is the normal bean is a purple and black bean. But since we grow so many different beans next to each other, all the bees cross-pollinate and make this crazy multicolored bean. Which actually gives it a real heirloom variety.
It looks almost psychedelic, but it looks very cool and very tasty.
Nature in full effect.
Seriously.
Beautiful.
So I think we're gonna take about a pound and a half.
Cool.
Yeah? All right, awesome, thank you.
Can't wait.
Ta-da. Awesome, thank you, man.
Thanks, Zach.
Appreciate it.
We're back soon.
All right, see you, Zach. All right, let's go.
Hey, everybody, we're back again.
We made it to Shayla's. We're in front of the door, and we've got all the ingredients from the market. We're ready for her to work her magic.
Including the pink scarlet beans, and we're about to get, what are we getting on?
We're getting our Puerto Rican on, brother.
Puerto Rican, baby.
Heck yeah. I always got it going on, because my mama's Puerto Rican. Shout out to mama, love you, mama.
You know, I've known this guy for about 30 plus years, and I don't know if I've told you that before, but.
You have.
You know, it's definitely rubbed off on me a little bit. I had that Puerto Rican ways since we first met, so.
Well, definitely rubbed off in your dance moves. This guy's got moves. God. We're gonna see him too. We're gonna put him on the spot.
No, I'm putting him on the spot like that.
Yeah, we are, it's gonna be great.
Dude, Shayla's a dancer, how am I gonna keep up?
Oh, you're gonna keep up. This guy's half Italian. He knows, he's got the moves.
Oh, Jesus. All right, well, here we go. Let's give her a knock and let's get the cooking on.
Let's do it.
Hey, Shayla.
Hey.
How are you? Good to
can
see
I
you.
Oh, damn, of course. Hey, I think a Puerto Rican,
Puerto Rican
handshake.
How are you guys?
Good.
This is Shayla.
Hi.
Ingredients?
Yes.
She was so kind to invite us into her home.
Oil?
Perfect.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
We just told the camera we're about to get our Puerto Rican on, so.
All right, let's get our Puerto Rican on. I couldn't hear the door knock because my music's on too loud.
Turn it up.
I was pre-partying.
Yeah. Nice.
Love that.
It's all about that
preheat.
Thank you.
All right, let's do it. What's up, everyone? We're inside of Shayla's house. Thank you, Shayla, so much for bringing us in.
You're welcome.
Appreciate it. You have a lovely place.
Thank you.
Can't wait to get down to business.
All right.
So, you know, first thing, I want to tell everyone a little bit about how we met, why we know each other, why you like us, I think.
Right? I met these great gentlemen. I used to go to the Manhattan Beach Farmers Market almost 10 years ago. And yeah. I found their little booth with olive oil, and I fell in love with the olive oil, and then I fell in love with the olive oil even more when I found out they were Puerto Rican too.
Yeah.
So.
Because it was my brother and I.
Yeah,
at the booth,
it
right?
was. It was when they were still working the booths personally, so I got the VIP experience.
How did they know you were Puerto Rican though?
Because I was wearing a Puerto Rican hat.
Because she had a flag.
It was the boombox. The boombox and the salsa music. Yeah.
And the smell of the rice and beans. I was like, she's got to be Puerto Rican.
I was like.
Yeah,
it's like you can't hide it.
Yeah.
No, but it was awesome, and I love the knowledge that these guys have about olive oil, the passion that they do it with, the energy of the olive oil. Everything just really vibrates really perfectly with my soul, literally, not just at a body level, and so many things that they taught me that I didn't know about olive oil and how much time it should be on the shelves and how it should be treated and how it should be processed or not processed.
Because you've always been pretty mindful of what you put in your body, and I mean you're physically active, right?
Yeah,
aren't you a dancer?
I used to be a dancer, and I'm in the fitness industry now, so I'm all about health and trying to find better ways to stay healthy and better products. And this is one of the few products that I've kept from day one till still forever because they're
awesome.
Amazing, seriously amazing.
Thank you so much. Well, you know, we went to the farmers market in Santa Monica, and we got these ingredients. We're really excited, obviously, for the bean, the scarlet red beans.
Pink scarlet.
Pink scarlet beans. Bad Puerto Rican. pink scarlet beans. And what's cool with them is that they're actually in season the whole year round. So you can always have rice and beans, which is wonderful for me to hear.
Yeah, I grew up in Puerto Rico, so rice and beans was a staple in my household. It was always there every day, no matter what meal you had rice and beans on the stove. And so I'm super excited because usually Puerto Ricans use pink beans, but beans, there's so many kinds of beans you can play with. It's really fun. So these are the pink scarlets, and I'm super excited to try to play with these.
Yes, can't wait.
So, okay, so these are our ingredients that these beautiful gentlemen brought for me to make my rice and beans. We got this amazing rice from the farmer's market.
Coda Farms. My favorite rice.
Awesome.
Lovely. Rice.
We got some beautiful cilantro. We've got garlic. You can never have too much garlic in any Puerto Rican household. We got avocados. We put these at the top at the end. Green bell peppers, red onion, tomato, and what is this?
What is it?
Really?
What?
Really?
Really what?
I said tomato sauce.
Tomato sauce.
This is not tomato sauce.
What do you mean? What is
it? This is marinara sauce.
Yeah.
No, marinara sauce. This, if you want it to taste like spaghetti.
Oh, damn.
Different country.
This is just like in my house.
No.
This is like with my wife. I told you to get the blue one, I get the pink one.
But I can imagine this might happen more than one would expect.
Can we get around this?
Yeah.
Okay, it's our lucky day because I have some. All right, it's you guys' lucky day. You don't get killed today because I have tomato sauce in the fridge.
I have tomato sauce. Wonderful.
Thank God, exactly what I need for it. But if you don't have tomato sauce, you have two options. You can go to your neighbor's house and ask for some tomato sauce and maybe, you know, ignite some beautiful new friendship forever.
Community cooking.
Or grab a tomato and mush the heck out of it and kind of make your own tomato sauce. You can even do it in the blender and put a little bit of salt in it. It's really what tomato sauce is and actually is better for you.
So little time consuming, but fresh.
Fresh. So, solve the problem.
All right, so we have all these fresh ingredients.
Yes, and just as important as the beans, what olive oil you use. So
gotta be fresh.
Gotta be fresh, gotta be good.
So we brought two.
Okay.
Why do you know, we have our all-purpose sort of, which is our, you know, all-purpose you can cook with and all that. And then this is really our finishing oil. Why did you ask for the two?
So I asked for I use this, it's kind of like their everyday oil. It's kind of easier. It's more universal.
It's more universal. Yeah, exactly.
It's easier to go with so many more things.
More Utah, yeah.
More Utah for sure. It's more universal. Like you can literally use it for everything. That's what's called every day. And this one is a stronger blend. And it actually, the stronger it is, the higher in nutrients it is. And I just love the bitterness that it has, and it's bitterness in a good way, I'm saying it. And so I usually finish the rice and beans with it on top because I try not to cook this one because I don't want to kill the nutrients in it. So it just adds, it kind of like brings the whole dish together at the end because you can really taste the olive oil and the properties it has, and it's like super earthy and just amazing. It's my favorite.
And that's exactly how Italians or people in the Mediterranean, that's how they use a strong oil like that as like a finishing. You know, like how people in the US might use ketchup, like as a condiment, as a sauce, that a good fresh oil like that, what you're doing is exactly sort of the way it's always been intended.
And that's funny because I grew up using the same oil that my parents used to cook. They used it as a finishing oil.
Right.
And as soon as it's just a totally different experience.
Yeah,
it's amazing. So that's why I asked for specifically these two, because I always use these two when I cook.
Perfect.
Rice and beans.
Voila.
All right, well, let's get started.
Let's do it.
All right, let's do this. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my peppers, my onion, and my tomato, and I'm gonna chop them up. I'm gonna take my garlic, and I'm gonna show you two ways to do the garlic in just a little bit. But these are this is the first step. Chop up your stuff. Okay, so the traditional Puerto Rican way to do garlic is using the pilon, and you can put the garlic in here, you put olive oil, oregano, salt, you mush it. But I'm gonna give you an option. If you don't have a pilon, all you can do is like mince your garlic, basically. Just mush it, and then cut it very, 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 very little, but as tiny as you can, almost like in a creamy way. That's how you would be mushing it in the pilon.
Okay, so first I put my pan at slightly under medium heat because I don't want to burn my pan. I let it sit for a little bit.
The magic.
The magic, it is magical. So I pour kind of 2 tablespoons. I don't know, you can never have too much of this. It's like garlic, olive oil. You can never have too much of it. So you let it warm up for a little bit. First, you put the onions in because you want them to kind of soften a little bit first. There's some pepper sneaking, it's okay.
And you do red onion, huh?
Red onion. It's my favorite. You can do any onion. Yeah. My mom does yellow onion. Okay, so the secret is, okay, so I use this, adobo, sazon. This is like the traditional Puerto Rican, but I'm gonna teach you how to make it so you can have access to the ingredients. So I'm gonna do it, my plan B, okay? And it's healthier too. So I use Himalayan pink salt, oregano, and it's like, few pinches. You always put extra love in it. 1 bay leaf. This is very important. This is like the most important seasoning that you can put in Puerto Rican beans. Just don't eat it. Okay, so you pan fry it. A little bit, in it a little bit. Literally like maybe 2 minutes. And then I'm gonna add the peppers. So the peppers and the onions take the longest to kind of soften up a little bit. So it's the first 2 things I put. That's what I put. And I kind of am always adding seasonings as I go because I just, that's the way I do it. It's a Puerto Rican thing.
Share the magic with us, Shayla.
Yes. A little salt, a little more. So usually with the adobo, like we use adobo like salt. It's got other ingredients, got garlic. So then I'll do like maybe garlic salt a little bit to make up for the lack of adobo. A little bit more oregano. Why not? And finally, we can dance. This is actually a good dance break.
And there's usually music going on.
Yes, there's always music. And literally, like, I make my kids do a dance break with me. They must. The older they get, the more they complain, but that's okay. I still make them do it.
Well, that sounds like it's part of the recipe, so I'm gonna need to see a dance break.
Hey, dance break. We got a perfect dance break. Let's go. Hey, you got it.
Hey! It's the basic, right?
Yeah, that's the basic stuff.
So it's basic on me. What else you got?
That's good. We'll do a turn next.
Okay.
Okay, so now, so see how these, like, the onions are getting kind of clear a little bit? So see how the onions are getting slightly translucent, clear,
you got it.
A little bit. Okay, so I'm gonna add the garlic, but the secret, the important thing to know with the garlic is you can only pan fry it for maybe a little less than a minute, because if you do it more than that, it'll get really bitter and it'll change the flavor of the dish. And what you do is the tomatoes kind of stop the cooking of the garlic, so I'm gonna put the garlic in for like 40 seconds and then add the tomatoes on top, and that will stop the cooking of the garlic so it doesn't get bitter.
Oh, you're
good. Tomatoes. I'm gonna do both. I'm gonna have the tomato sauce and a little bit of water.
Sure.
I just poured water in the tomato sauce. Usually if you have the tomato can, you kind of pour it in the can. No tomato sauce left behind. Okay, so I'm adding my beautiful beans that we soaked overnight.
They do look gorgeous.
They are beautiful beans. They're actually really good. Really pretty. Yeah. They're so pretty. We are ready to plate our food.
Woo!
Yes. Woo! Woo! Okay, so I plate it, but you can have creative license however you get inspired to. Rice. In Puerto Rico, we actually use an ice cream scooper to make like perfect little rice balls.
Yeah.
It's pretty funny.
We call them castillos.
Yes, yes,
that's my grandma,
yes.
Little castillo.
Okay, that's and then you get the beans. Wow. And then. Okay.
We're gonna bring it over here.
Gorgeous.
And I'm going to put some aguacate. That's avocado. Usually, it's like the easiest way to do it. I do it different ways, but if you just use a butter knife, not a sharp knife, and just go like this.
Qué rico.
I kind of have to do the sound effects because they're more fun.
Of course.
And this is the early harvest. This is the, like, really beautifully pungent, super nutritious olive oil. We kind of drizzle it.
You're getting jealous on the isla.
I like the smell.
Drizzle it on
all
top.
Of it.
And here is Puerto Rican rice and beans.
Do you want to pick it up and... Done.
All right, this is done. I can't wait to bring this to Everett. So we're gonna bring it to the farmer and we're gonna present him the dish.
We're gonna let Justin do the honors first.
What?
I'm Puerto Rican, I cooked for like a village. There's plenty for the farmers.
Are you sure?
Yes, yes, yes.
You think this guy needs to eat?
Can't say no.
He do the honors.
All right.
I'll share with you, Josh.
You don't like avocado?
Oh, I know, I know.
You think we can share forks?
Right. I think so.
We're close enough.
We've shared more than forks.
I don't know.
What?
Super, super tasty, Sherlock.
You like it?
I do.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, the beans are so much better fresh.
Yeah, it makes a huge difference. Huge
what
difference.
A taste.
It's worth the time.
Let's finish this and not give any to Carlos.
Carlos, get in here, man.
Time to eat, Carlos. Oh my God, that was so good.
So delicious.
There's one bean left.
I'm gonna get it.
Can we split it?
Yeah,
can we split it?
Can we split it? Okay, let's see.
Oh.
But now we can't do it again.
Oh, there nice. All right. Yay, I got a bean.
Thank you, Shayla.
Cheers.
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 Cheers. That's a good
Get to the
bean.
Last bite. Well,
right.
Everett's gonna be in heaven, because
he is.
Shayla, great job. Wow, high five.
I packed up some stuff for the farmer.
Whoa!
Give her and a high his five. Family.
Yeah, thank and his Shayla. Family.
You rocked it.
That was fun.
This
that
is great.
That was a lot of fun.
I feel educated, full, a happy man.
Yeah.
It doesn't take much more than that.
Oh, I wanted to add one thing. If you have kids and you want to hide veggies in your beans, chop up some spinach or kale or any veggie that you have, and they will never know. That one was free.
But she charged me, so free for you. Thanks, Shayla.
All right.
All right, awesome.
Are we supposed to be doing some dancing now?
Let's see it. There's so much soul that went into this food.
Come on.
Let's see it. I know, at the end, you gotta feel it.
Right.
All right. Thank you for joining us in the kitchen of Shayla. We're Josh and Justin. Carlos behind, making the magic happen.
And that's it. Another episode of In Season. Up. Yeah. Spin it. They could be here all day, but we're gonna go. See you later. And it's time to leave, and they're still dancing. Oh, we gotta go, Justin. Justin, we gotta go. Justin. I said, come on, let's go. Hello? There are people waiting for food. Oh my God, these Puerto Rican stars dancing. Come on, let's go. Let's go. Oh my goodness. Once they start, they don't stop. And they're still dancing. Oh my God. Come on, we're late, guys. We gotta go. What's up, everyone? Josh and Justin. We're back at the Santa Monica Farmers Market with the food.
Another beautiful day over here. We just came from Shayla's house. I'm still high off that experience and all the dancing we did, but I'm really excited to give Zach the dish that she made for him and see what he thinks. But I'm pretty sure she nailed it.
She definitely nailed it. Let's go find out. Let's put it to the test.
Okay.
All right.
Hey, Zach. So we just came from our chef's house.
And what was Mama's name again? We didn't meet Mama the first time.
Hi, guys. I'm Lori.
Lori. Lori's the actual pioneer.
Well, thank you. And the next generation, right?
And the next generation, exactly.
The younger generation.
Love that. Love that. Well, we got some of the pink scarlet beans, the runners. Made Puerto Rican style, and we'd love for you to try it and let us know what you think.
Happily.
This is what it's all about. Full circle. Yeah. Here we go.
Oh yeah.
This is from farm to fork, back to the farm.
Oh yeah. That's delicious.
Yes. She nailed it.
Lori?
Wow, I can't wait. Are you going to give me some?
He's a hungry boy.
I think he's hungry this morning.
It's my breakfast.
Wow.
That is still
really
good.
It's very, very good, guys.
It's good?
It amazes me. Even holds its color. It's delicious. Absolutely delicious.
Oh, that's awesome.
Wow.
That's what it's all about, right? Fresh ingredients in the hands of people who know what they're doing, because sometimes farmers like us, you know, our expertise kind of ends at the kitchen. But we're trying.
We're good at growing, not really good at cooking.
Yeah, but you know.
But if we get recipes,
we know how to follow directions.
Yeah, all right, you definitely will have the recipe for sure.
Yeah, we'll have it for sure, yeah. But thank you again so much for making this outstanding food. And I mean,
it's really nice as a farmer to see what our product does with such awesome recipes like you guys and stuff.
Thank you. Well, thank you again. This really means a lot, especially for me, because, you know, my mom's Puerto Rican, so I love sharing our culture, little slice of our culture, you know, with other people as well.
And the spices are crazy. I don't really know what Puerto Rican spices are, but
that's
I would like to
good.
Know.
Good. Awesome. Another convert.
Thank you for thinking of us and supporting us and getting our beans.
Appreciate it.
Being able to share your recipe.
Thank you so much. Yep. Two peas in a pod.
Sorry.
Still dancing?
I'm still feeling it, man.
Oh my goodness, this guy never stops. Nah, I love it.
I love it too.
I know. You know, you got the rhythm in ya.
Well, that was an awesome episode.
I mean, I still got the rhythm in me from that episode.
Right?
Jeez.
I mean, we had incredible cooking.
The best.
We had great stories.
Wow, two peas in a pod, taking that risk, doing something that nobody was doing in that area. And
amazing.
Now they've blown it up into one of the largest pea producing areas in California. I mean, that's fantastic.
It really is. And I think that's what I love so much about doing this, Josh, is that we get these little nuggets of information and these great, beautiful people and stories that maybe you wouldn't have gotten if we weren't kind of asking the questions or just doing this.
We're in the market all the time and we didn't know about it. Half that stuff.
I know. It really is something special. And it's all right here in our backyard.
I know, right? Exactly. That's what I really want. I'm hoping that people will understand what's in their backyard. You can just go right outside and you can get the best ingredients, fresh, healthy, and you can eat well and feed yourself well.
Yeah, I mean, it's all about taking care of each other, taking care of oneself, and it's really what we need now more than ever.
We do.
You know?
We need each other.
We do.
We need each other more than ever.
Well, listen, thanks everybody for all your love and support, for always tuning in. We're gonna do more of these.
We're coming back for more, so we're gonna see you again soon.
In the meantime, stay tuned.
Stay healthy.
See you soon. Take care.
Please be sure to subscribe, like, comment, and go to our website, NuvoOliveOil.com, for simple recipes, fresh ingredients, for a healthier lifestyle. Stay healthy, friends.